14% ऑफ अवर पॉपुलेशन गो टू बेड स्लीप हंग्री।
माई फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज व्हाट इज सॉफ्ट स्किल्स ladies and gents,
how to communicate with the person who don't know, how to communicate with the strangers, how to behave with them.
I am not cabin crew, but I am preparing cabin crew. Like I don't have soft skills, so how can handle passenger,
something extra to someone. So in return you will get in multiples from the god.
Right, well said.
Treat as they are our servant, they are also human, and they also want respect.
Whose commitment to spread happiness from his happiness institute?
As we have done cabin crew activity, the soft skills come through us.
Do you think that they lack soft skills? That they are very serious. They don't joke. They don't fun. They don't smile. They don't laugh. What would you like to say about this point? Once more, good afternoon. Okay, so I hope that this is an amazing session. Sleepy, don't say sleepy. Say I feel enthusiastic, right?
Yes.
You took the lunch, heavy lunch, and you are saying sleepy.
Yes, sir, that's why I'm feeling.
You took paneer tikka and all, and you know, you took multiple dishes. So today we have actually a very special GD group discussion. In this group discussion, we are going to share our views and points about hospitality industry and hospitality management, and especially soft skills. What is soft skill? Soft skill is the skill which includes communication, leadership, team management, hospitality, and cabin crew, air hostess, and all these skills are soft skills. Do you like soft skills?
Yes.
What is Happiness Institute known for?
Soft.
Developing soft skills. I will just have a random question. If anyone has answer of that question, he or she will raise his or her hand, and he or she will say, I want to say, or I want to speak about this thing.
Okay.
Right?
Yes.
My first question is, what is soft skills, ladies and gentlemen?
So, good afternoon, Ed Educator. Good afternoon to all team members. And
Keep your hand off the table. Yes.
It's my pleasure to greet all of you. And I would like to thank our honorable Ed Educator, Mr. Abdullah sir and Sadaf ma'am, for giving me this opportunity to speak over here. So, as sir mentioned that, what does soft skills mean? Before that, I would like to say about skills, what does skills mean? So, skills are the abilities which require some expertise to perform a work. And after that, it bifurcated in two parts, that is hard skills and soft skills. So hard skill is the skills which require some technical knowledge to perform a job work, and it come through job training and some type of a professional work. And if we say about the soft skills, as this is our group discussion topic, so it is the ability which came through interaction with the personal interview, personal talks with some activity like communication we can do. As we have done cabin crew activity, the soft skills come through as cabin crew activity, and it come through interaction with the people, with the friends and with the people.
Thank you so much, so Akshat, to share your points.
It becomes very necessary to have soft skills with the which plays very important role in our daily life.
Thank you. I have another question, that for example, if we don't have soft skills, so what are the disadvantages and what are the loss that we may face? Please, Simran.
I talk about the disadvantages. First of all, I want to tell about the advantages. If we have our soft skills, then we can build our character, then we can build our personality. It enhances our personality. It's the way that how to talk with anyone, how to interact with the strangers. If we don't have the soft skills, so that time we don't have any idea how to communicate with the person who don't know, how to communicate with the strangers, how to behave with them. This makes a bad impression in front of anyone. We have to build our personality. If we have to enhance our personality, so we have to make soft skill in ourselves.
I just asked the question that what if we don't have soft skills?
If we don't have soft skills, so we don't have a good personality. We can't show the gestures where we have to show to the guest or the strangers. We don't even know the correct way to communicate with the person. Having soft skill, it means we have a positive personality, we have a positive mindset. Without having a soft skill, it is difficult to having a positive personality or a positive mindset. So that's why soft skill is important, because we have to build a good character and a positive character.
Thank you so much, Shivra. That's nice. I have my third question with me. For example, when we visit any hotel or the flight or airline. So what the things as a passenger, as a client, as a customer, we keep in our mind? What kind of services, what kind of gestures we want from the servers, from the attendants, and from the people that who are serving us? What kind of gesture and what kind of behavior we want from them, we expect from them as a customer or as a passenger? Please.
Like this times I am not cabin crew, but I am preparing cabin crew. Like I don't have soft skills, how can handle passenger. Like if I have soft skill, that's why I can handle everything.
My question is that if I am a passenger,
yes sir,
what can I expect from you as my flight attendant?
Sir,
what will be my umid? What will be my ashay? What
sir,
will be my expectation?
You will accept like my behavior, my nature, and how will I serve you food also, and all these things.
Thank you. That's very nice. You also want to say something about this, Akshat?
To them that they should be clear of them serving the that they are serving food like and how they serve more. And their behavior, what the way of talking, the way of their personality to the passengers, and the passenger also want that they should have a good behavior and good personality, good dress up, so that they look like some enthusiastic person, and it would get better life.
Thank you so much for this. The fourth question is that I have great soft skills or effective soft skills. For example, I have built through my benefits personally and professionally, and what can I add into my lifestyle after having and developing soft skills?
After developing soft skill, we can manage our time as well as we can get a job also, as we can see that we can communicate to other people very normally, how we can start a business and build our personality also, confident, and how to talk to people, as well as achieving soft skill.
Well said. I have my fifth question with me, that some people are there who are quite serious in their lives, right? Who don't make fun, who don't be jolly, who don't be humorous. Do you think that they lack soft skills? That they are very serious. They don't joke, they don't fun, they don't smile, they don't laugh. What would you like to say about this point?
Sometimes we can say that some people is very serious in our life. Don't mean that it is serious. So no, it is serious for everyone. But when is your close friend with your close friend? Where she is, that is not serious with your close friend. And he is talented. It's not so he's serious. No, you that cannot learn. And so, but
no, I'm talking about that seriousness. How much importance there is of the seriousness, right? Should we be always serious, or we should be sometimes jolly, funny?
Yes, sometimes jolly, funny, not every time serious.
Not every time serious.
Yes.
Seriousness is not good always.
Seriously,
am I serious this time?
No, you are not serious.
I'm not
this
serious.
Time. No.
I'm talking about very serious topic and I'm not serious.
We all are serious.
After this session, are we going to be serious or are we going to be
more jolly?
What are we going to do after this session?
Dance
is for seriousness or for fun?
For fun.
Mr. Vikash, I want to ask to you.
As per my opinion, this soft skill is very, really very important. Whatever we do in knowledge is just is about 20 to 30%. How you present in front of your the person who take interview, so how you present, because the person who is just in front of you, he know that you have at that time, right? Like nowadays, if you think we are saying that India is going great in their for external affairs, this is not because Mr. Modi or the Ajay Shankar, they are very knowledgeable, but the fact is they both are very expressible. The whole world,
right,
listen to them, because they what we can say, like they
They have skilled themselves.
Yeah, they have skilled themselves. They in a very effective manner.
Right.
So all they are very good in their communication skills.
Right.
And like many people are good in sales.
Right.
So sales also require a good your
soft skills.
Soft skills. Right.
Right.
Sales is the most important part in any organization.
Right.
Because without sales, you would not have any profit.
Yeah.
So right. The organization may be not run without those person who express themselves in right. front of the customer.
Right.
If you talk to them, maybe in knowledge they are they will not stand in front of you. They know how to sell their product in front of you.
Well,
just
said.
Because of their
skills. All right. Well said. That's amazing. That's fantastic.
Okay. Soft skills become so important part in everyone's life. So everyone should learn about the soft skills and should take coachings and should join
so clubs. Excellence Institute are also teaching about the soft skills, so that personal development and
communication
skills. So as right. body, you can join
I have 2-3 more questions with me, and I want this time answers from those people who have not spoken actually, right? I don't want the repeated people. I want new people, fresh people. First of all, my first question, a very simple question I want to ask, that today we have conducted the hospitality management skill or activity skills, right? I want to know the benefits and the profits it's going to play in our lives and in our development of soft skills, right? So what is the exact meaning of the soft skill? What is the purpose of this today's activity? What would you like to say that what are the profits of this? Please.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Today we learn from this activity when we will come there, restaurant or in flight, we learn the more things, how to manage in difficult situation, how to provide service to the customers, or how to manage or other things in the hotels. How to polite to customers, replace these things, replace this food, I don't like this food, you replace this. But how to manage, how to provide service to person again and again, and how to communicate with them in a polite way.
Well said, well said. So the answer is very simple, that we just got to know that how to serve that person again and again, right? After being so much staying polite, right? My second last question, I will come to the second last question. What are the exact bad manners in the hospitality industry or in the cabin crew industry or in any soft skills industry that we do or we get from the customers and from the people? Just for example, we don't give the tips, or we just call the, hey waiter, come here.
Behavior.
Or behavior, the nature, the wording,
so, sir, you are
from the customers and from the both side. I'm talking about the in the soft skills industry. What are the bad manners?
Actually, sir, we go to any hotel and restaurant. So you sit properly and you talk to other person, then waiter. So you speak to polite and you say something like you don't know how menu. What's menu? Okay, say to sir, please excuse me sir, please you read this menu and you tell me what's special you're in your restaurant, what's special in this day. So your bad thing is this, you talk to waiter like hello, what are you, this is not correct.
You should be polite.
Yeah, you should be polite and you should don't misbehave to waiter.
Right. Well said, well said. Nadeem.
So my name is Muhammad Nadeem. I would like to talk about cabin crew students and all students. After sitting in the plane, we can say there is not allow here to there looking.
To move and to just, to you know,
just
shake the body.
Shake a body and here to there don't go we. And I can say there is not allow any smoking is not allow and yes, in the plan.
So we should maintain the decorum and the manners.
Good manners we have.
Mr. Sami.
Server which provides, which gives service us, we should not treat as they are our servant. They are also human and they also want respect.
Right.
So we should not treat them badly,
right?
Yeah, and
that's great. Well,
the customer, we should respect his work. The people who is serving us, we should respect his work. Like many people do not think about it. They just call, hey waiter, come here and do this for me. What we can say, personal experience. If we talk very nicely to them, so many times they favor you. I have seen many times.
Right.
So, so we should respect them because no work is less important or more important. Every work is equal.
Right. Right.
So, apart from this, if we talk about the tips, tips and all. So in India, this culture is very new, and like 99% of us, we not give them a tip. But if we talk about the Western countries, so there is a tip culture.
Right.
Not only in this restaurant which he is passing to you, it is giving you the good vibes, the positive vibes that will make your day.
Right.
And you, and you believe me, if you are start giving something extra to someone, so in return you will get in multiples from the God.
Right. Well said. Well said.
Say some things about soft skill. Sir, soft skill is like a person who has soft skills. So like,
अरे वाह, that's amazing.
So soft skill is very important. If you want to become teacher, if you want to become cabin crew, and as well like you have, sir, have done that activity, hospitality. So soft skills very important.
Well said. Well
so
said.
So that's all about my side point.
All right, everybody.
And so how to actually behave and adapt ourselves in different situations and scenarios?
Yes, yes.
We have come to understand that. All right. So that's really nice. This is also soft skills.
Yeah.
Right. This is the part of soft skill. I feel that you would be feeling amazing today,
yes,
right?
I am
so much honored to get you here, yes, sir, to receive you. This is also the part of soft skill. Being polite to somebody,
right, yeah,
being humble to someone, right?
Yeah.
I hope that it would be amazing.
Is this, you can, what is this? This is a sign of this is the sign of soft skills and kindness, right?
Yes.
So we should be very humble and sweet with all the people. Right, Aknoas?
Yes, sir.
Are you distinguished guest, respected Abdullah sir, and my dear friends, a very good evening to all. My name is Muzammil and I am a student of Happiness Institute. It is both a privilege and an honor to stand in front of you. Not only we are gathered to enjoy this meal, but to remember the importance of this meal. We are stand here in front of you today on reflecting on an issue that is deeply connected to every act of our dining. We are here to discuss about the topic that is connected to everyone who are living in the globe. As we are gather, as we are share this meal together, as we are sharing this meal together, let us remember that every grain on our plate holds a potential to heal, to nourish, to sustain a life. And yet now, a huge amount of food wasted globally each and every day. In today's presentation, I aim to shed light, the light on the magnitude of food wastage and its devastating impact, and a small and significant step we can take to curb this crisis. I feel deeply grateful for the presence of WHO's commitment to spread happiness from his Happiness Institute. Let us embark together for this journey as we explore how we can contribute in the world where food is respected, valued, and saved for those in need. Imagine the mother who has nothing to feed, cry his children. And imagine the father who is unable to provide a single time of meal for his family. Imagine the small children and the animal who is searching a food in the dump yard and waiting for your throwing food. Let us ignite the sense of responsibility towards society. According to global perspective, of 1.3 billion tons food are wasted in a whole year. 1.3 billion food wasted in a whole year. this is a big amount. This amount of food, in that we could feed the pupil two times who is undernourished. Two times who is undernourished. As we are talking about hunger index, India ranked 107 out of 121 countries. India is a country with vast resources, but 14% of our population go to bed sleep hungry. It approximately 189.2 million people have no food at the night. Around 68 million ton of food wasted alone India, and this food is enough for the whole population of Egypt for the whole year. If we are talking about economical impact, India wasted a food around the cost of 92,000 crore, and if this amount is used for awaring the pupil and nourish the pupil needed for this food. Now, I am talking about the social impact of food wastage. It is our moral responsibility, because food wastage create inequality and injustice in the society, because everyone have a right to take food. If I talking about environmental consequences, food wastage is end with the landfills and create a methane gas which is 25% more dangerous than carbon dioxide. Huge thing that we have to think about that. Now I have some points for our hospitality department. If they are applying these points, and if they all take my point seriously, so we could decrease the food wastage. Accurate demand forecasting. If our hotel industry accurate demand forecasting and analyze the trend of customer, like Sunday and Saturday, customer will increase and the weekend day decrease. So we can analyze the food quantity required of food. This will help us a lot. Second point is compositing. If you all are create a compositing area beside your restaurant or hotel, so this will create a very helpful thing for gardening, compositing for the waste from the waste material. A particular area for compositing we can hire and use the vegetable and fruits, and this will help in gardening. We are smartly planning a menu. We can smartly planning a menu that 10 dishes are made on same ingredient with different flavor. So this will also decrease the wastage of food. Now, as a citizen of India, that 40% of food are waste in restaurant industry, which is made for human consumption due to improper structure of serving, due to consumer waste or anything else. As a citizen of India, we have some points that if we are apply in our daily life, so we can reduce the wastage of food. Like, plan your meal. Don't overbuying. Predict the meal that in this week or in this month, if you needed a particular quantity of fruits and vegetable required, please buy that. Not buying over. Not overbuying, please. So plan your meal smartly. We can reduce, with the help of this, we can reduce the food wastage. And proper storage on the outer side that we can take easily and use as a first. So we can store lots of food in backward area. So this is also help in reducing the food wastage. Leftover food. My mother is the best example of use leftover foods. She was made a Indian khichdi for me.
She made a
Indian khichdi for me, and last night the left rice are fried with eggs and make a new dish for me. So they utilize the left rice for me. White plain rice are left in from my dinner, or my mother use in a kheer also. So use leftover. Packed left food. If you are going, when you are going to the restaurant, so the food is left, please packed and give the needed pupil. कि एहसास लोग समझ नहीं पाते क्योंकि वो भूखे नहीं सोते हैं, और भूख के एहसास वो समझ पाता है जो भूखा सो पाता है. थैंक यू एंड हैव अ नाइस डे.